I think I rushed the end of that problem just to finish in the 10-minute YouTube time limit. And I just want to make sure you understand, because I kind of did it all over the place. We said, well, you know, white to brown is 2 to 3. And then, you know, we just can kind of solve for, you know, white is equal to 2/3 times the brown. And we also say, well, the total number of the basket is white plus brown. White is 2/3 of the number of brown. So 2/3 brown plus, you know, 3/3 brown, or, you know, one brown, that equals 5/3 brown is equal to the total, right? Or we could multiply both sides of this times 3/5 and say that the brown is equal to the total times 3/5. And since we can't have a fractional number of brown eggs, the total has to be divisible by 5. And if we look at the choices, the only number that's not divisible by 5 is choice B, is 12. All the other choices are divisible by 5, so they could have been possible choices. Let's move on to the next. Oh, I got double here. Okay, there we go. And I will do it in green. 7. If 18 root 18, if 18 times the square root of 18 is equal to r times the square root of t, where r and t are positive integers, and we also know that r is greater than t, r is greater than t, which of the following can be the value of r times t? R times t. So this is interesting. R can't equal t, otherwise they would both be 18, right? But one thing, well, one interesting thing that we can kind of try doing. Well, actually, I'm not going to do it that way, because I realize that might be a long way of doing this problem. But let's see, how could we think about this problem? Well, we know that r and t are positive integers, so what could r and t be? 18 root 18. So we could factor this more. We could say that this is the same thing as 18 times, you know, 9 times 2, in which case this is the same thing as 18. We could, you know, square root of 9 is 3, times 3 times root 2. So what's 3 times 18? That's 54 root 2. So this would satisfy this format. So we could say r is 54 and t is 2, in which case rt would be 108. Let's see if that's a choice. And it's a choice. So we're done, because that could be the value of rt. Maybe I just stumbled on it. I don't know if there's other choices. I won't think too hard about it. But that's the answer. I just simplified this a little bit, and I said that's the same. 18 root 18 is the same thing as 54 root 2. And so r is 54, t is 2. If you multiply them, you get 108, and that was choice C. Problem number 8, which I will do in yellow. Problem number 8, they have a fancy graph drawn there. Not a graph, a drawing. See the triangle, that's one side. That's one side. One side, and then we have another triangle inside this triangle. Right, just a triangle. Another triangle inside that triangle, and let's see what they wrote in addition to that. So this angle is B, this angle is C, this angle is A, this angle is B, this is B, and this is A. And they want to know, in the figure above, what is the value of C in terms of A and B? And I call this, if you've watched my geometry videos, this to me is the angle game. Because we're just going to try to figure out as many angles as we can, and then eventually we'll hopefully be able to figure out what C is. So we know this is B, and all of these combined form this supplementary angle, 180. So we know that this angle right here is 180 minus B, so it's minus 2B. Right? That's this angle right there. And then what's this angle right here? What's this angle? Well, this angle is 180 Well, now does that help us? Is that going to help me with this problem? Well, let's just keep, this is 180 minus a minus c. I don't think that helps us necessarily. This angle right here is going to be 180 minus a minus b, right? I should have drawn this bigger. This angle right here is also, because we have this inner triangle right here, that also is going to be 180 minus a minus b. This angle here is going to be 180 minus this angle, right? So it's 180 minus, let me do it in this color. It's 180 minus this angle, which we figured out was 180 minus a minus b. And we just figured out that because that was part of this triangle. So it's 180 minus a minus b minus this angle here, which is also 180 minus a minus b. I mean, it's really minus 2 times 180 minus a minus b. And if you simplify that, you'll get 180 minus, we have this twice, you could just simplify it. So it's 2 times 180 plus 2a plus 2b. I skipped a couple of steps, right? Because the negative distributes, and then you have 2a's and 2b's. And then if we simplify this, we get, see, this is 180 minus 360. So you get 2a plus 2b minus 180, right? I just simplified this, is this angle, right? And then we also know that this angle that we just figured out, plus b plus c is equal to 180. Plus b plus c is equal to 180. So let me move up here. I'm running out of space. So if we want to solve for c, and I don't like this purple's too dark, we just subtract everything. We subtract all of this from the other side, right? So c is going to be equal to 180 minus 2a minus 2b plus 180, right? Because I'm subtracting this from the other side, or that'll make it plus 180, minus b again, right? Minus b. So if we simplify this, so c is equal to 360 minus 2a, and then minus 3b. And let's see if that's a choice. Choice E is 360 minus 2a minus 3b. So I haven't made a silly error, which I thought I would have made. So you really just kind of keep, you know, you figure out this angle in terms of a and b, you figure out this angle in terms of a and b, then you figure out this angle in terms of this angle and this angle. So you just keep using the, you know, angles of a triangle add up to 180 property of triangles. Go to the next page. Oh, now we're on the free answer questions. Image clear. Image invert colors. All right. So they say, I think we have time for this one. 9. They say t to the third is equal to 351. What is 4t to the third? So the slow way of doing this is try to figure out what t is. The fast way is, well, 4t to the third, if t to the third is equal to 351, then 4t to the third, you just multiply both sides times 4. And so 351 times 4, 4 times 1 is 4, 4 times 5 is 20, 3 times 4 is 12, 1404. That's the answer. And I have 40 seconds left, so I'll wait for the next video.